Yo, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Sam and this is Mom. She's gonna help out with this video. Today we are going to do a fun little game. She has my Instagram up and she's going to scroll randomly and whatever her finger is on, she's gonna show me it and immediately I have to tell you the story behind that. Let's do it. Okay, you ready, Mom?
Uh-huh.
All right, go, poof.
Oh my god, Mom,
do you
scroll?
Aw, okay, this is cute. This is a picture of me and my two little guinea pigs. We named one Dre after Dr. Dre and another one Chance after Chance the Rapper. And I got them with my ex-girlfriend and they are our little prized possessions, so cute. I don't have them anymore, unfortunately, but I used to give them baths and snuggle like this and spend some quality time being the father and all, so very cute. Oh, I remember being so proud of this picture because I was like, ooh, I got that like shade directly center on my face. So my caption was split in two, dark and light. Ooh, yeah, someone commented, wow, you're attractive with heart eyes. And I was like, yes, because I wasn't on T yet. So I was like, fuck yeah. Yes. Can't write one song that's not about you. Can't drink without thinking about you. Is it too late to tell you that everything means nothing if I can't have you? This is probably one of my all-time favorite days because I love dance. I go every single week. I go to this studio called The Playground and I have a really hard time opening up and just feeling free. And they put me front and center too, which is scary, but I went for it and I had a lot of fun and it turned out pretty darn awesome, I think. I'm proud of that one. This is Nash Greer and Nash Greer. You can't tell the difference? It came from when I was on Vine and everyone thought I was Nash Greer or looked like Nash Greer. Actually, his younger brother, which is stupid because I was older. I was just pre-T, so I looked like I was 14. Nash Greer is pretty attractive, so people were comparing me to him and I thought I was hot shit because I wasn't a boy yet and I wanted to be a boy. Oh God, I look so emo here. I look happy emo. I dyed my hair black. I was like, oh, I'm casually happy about it, but in a dark way. Run
from the morning. Mom's favorite. Think I hit a
wall. Mom's favorite. Waking up in a cold sweat. Waking up in this cold bed. She's into it more than I am. Get in the babe. This is Mom's favorite, can you tell? She really listened to this one a lot. I was proud of this one because it shows my range, but then also it's perfectly reflecting some very deep emotional distress I was experiencing in that moment. Aww, this is baby me. Can you tell I was meant to be a boy? I just look straight up like a little boy here. I cut my hair this short because my sister cut her hair short and I was like, I wanna do whatever my older sister does. And then it ended up being like kind of perfect for me and I remember being really happy about it. Aww. This is me and Dad, and we're so cute. I'm giggling, and I'm a little girl here, so yeah, that's cute. Gah! Oh, God. God. This is all of my ID cards. It's a comparison, which is pretty cool because it's like 8th grade versus now. You just slowly see me transform into a male. I had to take a picture for San Francisco State and they were like, you can't have a hat. And then my hair was weird and I was in like mid-transition, so I looked like a pale thumb. That was like a hard little transition phase. Oh yeah. I was pretty proud of this one. I feel like I felt very handsome with my white hair. This is actually last summer. Last summer? Yeah, this is last summer when I dyed my hair for the first time white and it grew out and it was like perfectly quaffed that day, so I was like, grab my electric guitar and look really cool. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your love's got me looking so crazy right now. Looking so crazy in love. Got me looking so crazy in love. This video is over 4 years ago. This is pre-tea Sam. I look straight up like a teenage boy, but I'm a girl with a female voice. I was proud because I came up with those like piano chords and it worked really well, but it's always like crazy to hear my old voice because I forget that my voice was like freaking munchkin.
Hello, I just took my first shower. First time wearing a towel like this. The neighbors are right there. I don't care because I am boobless.
Can you tell that I've seen that a couple times? Yeah, this is such a good day. After you get top surgery, you have to wait to shower for like a week or two. And it's just nice to shower in general because you feel disgusting. But also, I was boobless like for the first time, seeing myself and wearing a towel, how guys always wear them. I was like really wanted that. And the neighbors were walking outside of our place. It was just such a cool moment. And I was like, turn on the phone right now, record this.
Hello. I just got out of surgery. And mommy's here helping me walk. It was a lot better than the last time because I think I knew what to expect. And the only reason I have tears are just because I'm thinking of all the trans people that have to go through so much. And it's hard, and I hope people understand.
Can I hold this because you're shaking?
What we have to go through. And my love goes out to all of those people that are struggling, no matter what it is. And I love you guys. And thank you for all your support through this because it means the world to me.
That was a very emotional day, if you couldn't tell. That was right after I had my second revision surgery, and I was on a shit ton of drugs, so I was very loopy, obviously. But why I was crying was because during that entire surgery, I was thinking about literally what I just said, of like how much transgender people have to go through, because this was now my third surgery, and it was hard, and it hurt, and it was uncomfortable, and I was scared, and that's just like something not that horrific to go through. You know, I still have like a family and I still have friends, and like transgender people can go through some really hard shit. So I was just thinking of that during the entire surgery. My mom was there during that surgery and she's here now. Come in the video.
With my baby boy.
We'll end there because that's a nice little note. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I thought it was kind of fun to like kind of stalk myself for a second and laugh at old things. And thanks mom for picking them out randomly. And I will be back next week for another video. I love you guys. Thanks for watching and talk to you later. Bye.